free. Just gonna go read the brief for now. From the last episode, we followed Ariel into a part of the Underdark, where she had met Armand. Called himself the Bishop of Grimmore Castle, Ariel had been given the chance to undergo a ritual in which she had to battle through visions of her past, her mother's, and eventually a huge umbral guardian, protecting the secrets of the drow. She succeeded, but is left unconscious, awakens to a room in which seems to be the undercity of Laramir, where Armand reveals himself to be the leader of the Brotherhood. Cedric and Ivan leave their home in another part of the city, escaping towards the Undercity with Isabel and Fafnir. They sought shelter in the Undercity, where Fafnir, out of the pair's curiosity, unwrapped Ivan's staff, which had transported Fafnir to a stasis world. And he had a run-in with a lady in black with an expressionless white mask. The lady in black scratches Fafnir for trying to wrestle the staff away from her. But he is brought back in front of Isabel with visible scars. The group then, in a strange turn of events, reunite and begin resting in the Rose House in Laramir, where Ben eventually greets them and told the group of the bad news of Ariel's father. Out of rage, the group follows Ariel to Gorwin's house, the head of the Elven Mining Company. The group then decide to trap, torture, and eventually kill the mining head for information that confirmed him as the man who had contracted the cell swords to kill the once head of House Dormer, Brutus Dormer. Shortly after those events, you leave the house undetected, and we begin to make our way towards the center of the city. What would the three of you like to do?
That was exhilarating.
Fafnir, I can't believe that just happened.
Well, we did discuss this. We were going to kill that man if he killed someone else. And he did. And
Fafnir didn't think that we would go through with it.
He deserved it.
Well.
Mm-hmm. Now what, Ariel?
I intend to meet Raziel, but I don't know where he is.
Raziel? Who is this, Raziel?
An arch druid I met in Laramir.
Oh. Looks at Fafnir. Now? What's the time like today?
You guys set off about in the afternoon to kill Gorwin.
Okay.
So I'd say it's about late afternoon now.
Mm.
You're still walking to within the city.
Yeah. Now?
He usually hangs out at the bar over there. Right?
Ariel points towards the what's the name of that place? The
that bar.
The Lonely Trespasser.
Oh, great! I was, I'm a bit famished from all the killing, so yeah. Make a beeline straight that way.
Alright, so the group begin heading towards the Lonely Trespasser. It's that tree hovel with a slash stone wall in that's next to it. So you just kind of walk through the hovel. The bar is sort of empty at this point. You see that orcish bartender tending. Welcome, welcome. Have a seat. I haven't seen you in a few days. She points towards Isabel.
What?
Oh, really? felt like yesterday I was right here. This is the place with the watery broccoli, isn't it?
This one is not working.
Yep.
Oh.
Wow. Oh, you guys went there.
Yeah. Another one of your soups, please. And some pickles.
Sure, coming right up. It's a cauliflower soup.
Right.
Right, so he kind of just like goes behind and just gets something from a cauldron kind of situation. Puts it in like a very squarish bowl. Hands it over to you. What about you, young lady? Anything you want?
Nothing. Has Master Razio been here recently?
Master Razio? He usually comes by at dinner time. Should be in a couple of hours from now.
Very well. I shall wait for him. Can do. Watery as ever.
Make a constitution saving throw.
What? 14.
Yeah, it's downright horrible. At this point, you kind of just can't wait to just get your hands on some meat.
Okay. They don't serve meat here.
It's a very vegan conscious city.
Okay.
Well, they don't have meat.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I'll nod the pickles.
Alright.
Say, Ariel.
Yes?
Nothing? You don't feel anything?
No.
I mean, you're not bad, Penelope. I dig her, but well, I thought it would go more diplomatic than that, but I guess he wasn't a very nice man after all.
No, he was not.
Did you see that wart on his face?
Had a wart on his face?
Was that a wart or was that a triple chin? I'm not sure.
Okay.
He's just...
I believe that was his chin.
Ah! Well... Anyway...
You're familiar?
Yeah.
Okay, gosh.
Where's the half orc?
He's left.
We don't know. We tried to search the rooms before, but... He's gone.
Why is he always gone?
Fafnir does not know.
No, they're not that. They're not best friends yet. He just up and left, and he left his. Did he leave his sword?
I'm sorry.
His sword.
No, his sword's gone too.
Oh, okay. Mm. I don't know. I think he's just the typical freeloader.
I see.
I have a feeling he might come again one of these days.
You must go to Ironhaven after we talk to Raziel.
And meet
the dwarves and my little brother.
You hear the bells start ringing throughout the city.
Mm.
There's a bit of a rush that's happening towards within the streets. The orc notices this and what's going on here?
What's going on?
Mm. What's that sound?
Well, that bell usually comes from the tower, but don't really know why that usually happens. I really hear it sometimes.
Oh. Is that an emergency? Do we need to get out of here?
Probably nothing. Oh, I finished your soup.
Power.
I'll finish this pickle. Good soup.
Do you think that's the bell? Do you think they found out Gorwin's dead?
No.
I'm sorry, who? Did you say Gorwin?
No, we said Dorwin.
Oh, his brother.
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh, who's Gorwin?
Yes, who is that?
Gorwin's that guy. Heads up the mining company around here.
Ah, I see.
The mining company in Laramere.
Well, yeah, I mean, they have a house here.
Oh, no, we're not talking about Gorwin. No, not
yeah,
at all.
Bell sure is ringing a lot. Why don't you guys stay here for a bit? I'm going to see what's going on outside.
Sure thing.
So he just kind of steps out of the bar. Leaves two of you alone. Three of you alone.
Is there anyone else in the bar?
It's pretty empty.
What are we going to do? What if they find out?
They won't find out.
Right.
Marco's in the living room with him.
What if Marco tells them and they trust him?
Why would they trust someone like Marco?
Have you seen how charming he is?
Not really.
Okay. Well, in any case, I think we should at least, Fafnir, you should probably might want to use that hat right about now.
This one?
Mm-hmm. The one I just gave you. Go on, unfold it.
So he just unfolds the hat and starts just like kind of wearing it.
Yeah. Remember when I changed myself into that ugly dork? Yeah. Focus your mind and channel your energy and try to turn into a beautiful, lovely lady like me. Now.
Thoroughly blame me. Okay. With a tiny flick of the hat and just turn with a swivel. This dragonborn suddenly turns into this sort of fat lady, kind of like a very very pale skinned, curly blonde hair. Wearing like a very rough house paladin armor.
Why are you wearing your armor? Take off your armor.
But I'm not wearing anything under this armor.
Don't you see? It's a disguise. You can be whatever you want.
I didn't want to see you, fat lady. Strip.
We'll make a dress or something. Or a cloak.
Well, I don't have a dress.
Well, it's fine.
I took one look in.
It could be my mom.
Kind of just tries to look around for a mirror. Just interested in what he looks like. And when he does, he just gives a very kind of like very weird smile.
Okay. I feel a bit safer now. There's no dragonborn around us. So
the door suddenly opens up from the entrance of the bar.
Nice.
Showing the orc just coming back in. Just walking back into the back of the bar. Well, it's funny you guys should mention Gorwin. They just found out he's dead.
That's unfortunate.
Yeah.
I still don't know who that is.
It's fine. They caught the killer, though. So that's pretty over, right?
I see. Well, what'll happen to the mining business then?
Oh, it'll be fine. Those elves still figure something out. Well, what kind of line of work are you guys in?
Oh, we're just travelers.
I'm a tree hugger.
Ah, plenty of trees in Laramere.
Yes, I've noticed.
Makes a lot of sense.
So, Raziel's not around yet, eh?
Well, it's only been 15 minutes. Give him time.
Okay.
Alright. So, does Raziel visit this place often?
Well, comes here from time to time. Doesn't really keep to a schedule, but does come around dinner time.
Dinner time.
Yeah.
And what does he usually eat?
Well, right there, what that young lady over there just had. A bit of a cauliflower soup. Seems to be our house special.
Yeah, it's great.
I don't really know why people ordered it though. Sometimes it's made out of week old cauliflower. And, sometimes it's not even cauliflower, if you know what I mean.
What?
Give a hard wink to Isabel.
Pushes the bowl away.
Any meat?
Can't say that we serve any meat here in Laramir. Figured a tree hugger like yourself would be eating vegan stuff.
Right, of course. Do you have any dirt?
Well, we have a few shops down the road that serves a specialty dirt, but I don't think we serve any of that kind here.
You eat dirt in this place?
Yeah, it's pretty full of minerals and stuff. I mean, it's pretty much a special ingredient in the cauliflower soup.
Professor
again. Whoa!
I think I've had enough of this. Oh.
Yeah, don't break the furniture.
You've been very kind, sir.
Well, you guys seem to be the only part of business that shows up around here lately.
I wonder why.
Yeah.
Are there any fast routes to get to Ironhaven?
Ironhaven. Well, it's usually about a week's travel. That's the most direct route I know. Unless you can fly, right? Am I right? Well, if you guys don't need anything else, I better prepare for dinner.
That's right, yeah.
Yeah. So I'll be out in the back.
Oh, hold on. What about my friend here, Martha? Martha, do you want anything?
No.
I'm sure you want something.
But
space in your armor.
Maybe just water. So you go. Sure. A glass of water. A mug. Alright. Sure. Mm.
So, Ariel, do you know anything about the Raven Queen?
The Raven Queen? Do I know anything about the Raven Queen?
Go ahead and make a religion check.
Religion?
Yeah.
10.
10?
Yeah.
You had some inkling about it, but not in detail. You know her as the basic god of death.
Ooh.
Goddess, yeah, of death.
Like, what? Okay. No, I just know her as the goddess of death.
Because, I whisper to you, I think Fafnir had a run-in with her.
When?
I have suspicion. Just shortly before we met you, under that Brotherhood cave. That scar. Apparently she gave him that scar.
No, I thought he was in a dragon fight.
I don't know why he was trying to hide that information from you, but one second I was looking this way, and the next second he was rambling about seeing this lady with a blank face and a black garment, and his half of his face was bloody.
What do you mean she had a blank face? She had no face.
She had a blank face is what he said.
I don't understand Dragonborn language.
Well, I mean, that's what I've heard of the Raven Queen. She has a
blank face.
Oh, it could have been a mask. She usually wears a mask, but it might not be good for our friend here.
Yes.
Well, I thought you might want to know in case something does happen, because he does have a lot of stalkers. A lot of...
I'm not surprised.
Magical stalkers, doesn't he?
Being a dragonborn with no tail, I think mischief. He draws mischief to himself.
This is good water.
Ah, yes, Martha, yeah. Let me have some of that.
No.
Okay.
Sheesh. So.
Ooh. By the way, before we got to Iron Haven, you think we could go back to the Rose house again? I think I left my cage in there.
Right. Yes, perhaps we should.
As soon as we meet this Raziel person.
Yes. I don't know if he will...
show up?
Yes. He's very eccentric.
Oh, is he?
Yes.
That makes...
incredibly eccentric. I recall undergoing multiple trials that were very peculiar. I got eaten by a frog.
Ooh!
Yes.
What was it like?
Inside the frog?
Mm-hmm. I hear they're very slimy.
Inside and out.
I see. How did you manage to get out?
I killed it, I think.
Oh, is that what you were supposed to do?
No.
Oh.
Unfortunately, I was not supposed to kill a living being.
Well, that's to be expected.
Of the druids, yes.
What, is that all you did? Are you excited to meet this man?
I'm not sure. He did have a thing for my mother.
Ooh!
Yes.
Juicy.
Yes.
Does that mean he has a thing for you too?
No, I hope not. Oh. That would be very disgusting.
Well, it's disgusting only if he's ugly. Or if he's poor. But I'll judge that later as soon as he comes.
Yes.
An hour passes by. Still nothing.
Huh. Well, Ariel, he's taking a long time.
As that happens, a knock on the door just happens to go. A very, like, a fist-to-door kind of situation.
Ooh, who knocks doors here? Isn't this a bar?
Yeah, it's a bar.
Yeah, it's funny because they knocked.
They're being polite.
But that knock comes in again. Barkeep! Wait a minute! You kind of hear in the back. You kind of just peeks out. How could that be?
Why is it locked even?
It's not.
Oh.
Why would they lock?
So the barkeep just kind of like heads out towards the door, opens up. What do you want? It's dinner time, come in. Not today. There's been a lockdown. Mayor has declared a state of emergency. No one's to leave their houses. Lock up your doors.
What?
But it's almost dinner time. Lock up your doors. Alright, fine. We've got customers in here. The city guard kind of looks at the two of you.
Oh, city guard.
You ladies live here?
No?
Staying at an inn.
We're enjoying our dinner. What's wrong?
Well, finish up and head out to wherever you're sleeping for the night. City's on lockdown.
Why is it on lockdown?
Found out a few murderers around.
Murderers?
Yeah.
I thought the culprit's been caught.
Alright then!
Oh.
No, he heads up and talks to the barkeep. Better not see these ladies back in an hour. Close up now. Alright, sir. The orc just kind of closes the door.
What?
Well, ladies, you heard the man.
Perhaps we can head to my family's house. But I do still want to meet Raziel. I wonder if I can remember where the forest is.
I'm already on my way out.
Alright.
Well, Ariel, are you coming?
Yes. So we're gonna head to the rest house.
Okay. So the three of you journey along and head into the rest house.
What does it look like on our way to the rest house?
It's pretty quiet, as a matter of fact. People are hurriedly heading back to their homes. Streets are still well lit, but a lot more empty than usual. Mm. You finally make your way back to the House Rose rest house. And you settle in.
Eesh, what was that about?
Do you think they know it was Marco who killed Gorman?
Even so. I'm sure they won't be able to track it back down to us.
Right, because he choked on food.
Mm-hmm. And if Marco spills that he saw two ladies and a dragonborn.
Well, we'll just have to keep Martha then.
Yes. Unless Fafnir wants to turn into something else.
Martha quite likes this farm.
okay.
Another smile.
I guess having a not so pretty lady around us won't attract so much.
Perhaps she can be the nanny.
Mm. Yes. Nanny Martha, that's what you are. I'm tired.
Oh, do I have to rest? I wanted to go to the forest.
Now, in the middle of the night? Well, it will be soon.
Yeah. Okay. Very well. We shall go in the morning.
Aren't you able to communicate with your druidic powers?
Communicate with Rosie?
Is there any way?
Without getting causing suspicion.
Why is it suspicious that you would contact your master?
Can druids contact other druids?
Not with the abilities you have now.
Druidic, speak druidic. Leave it hidden. Leave hidden messages. Ooh. What? How do you leave hidden messages? What can I do?
You don't have to. What's wrong with them?
Sensory effect. Wait, oh yeah, so... Wait, is there like a... Does this house have a lightning rod at the top?
As a matter of fact, it would be common to have a lightning rod in Laramere houses, especially the more uptown, upscale houses. Sure, yeah.
Okay. So I want to use Call Lightning before the long rest.
Okay.
So, wait, I can make clear skies, right? Can I?
If you have the spell prepared.
Oh, no, I just have Dreadcraft. Harmless sensory that fits within a 5 feet cube. 5 foot cube. Can't be that tall. Okay. So I'll just call lightning.
Okay.
Spell is. Actually, no! I'll conjure an animal.
Okay.
Wait, which animal remembers where the forest is? The. Is it the hippogriff or the griffin? Griffin, yeah.
The griffin would
remember.
Probably
yeah.
remember.
Okay, so I'm gonna conjure a griffin.
Okay. So you don't conjure lightning? You don't call lightning, you will conjure a griffin instead. Okay. For the better part of 5 minutes, he does show up.
Yeah.
But as you kind of move yourself up to the top of the roof,
mm-hmm.
you realize that the griffin refuses to kind of just to land in within the city limits of Varamyr.
Mm-hmm.
But it is hovering around.
Mm.
And it is waiting for your order.
Do I see this?
Where are you?
Where are we?
Ariel has found herself on top of the roof.
Oh, okay. No, I'm in my room.
Mm.
Okay. So, I'll just send a message with parchment.
Right.
It says, Dear Master Raziel, I am currently healthy and alive, and residing in House Rose Manor in Laramere. I would like to meet you soon.
Alright.
Please hurry.
Right, so you pass this message along to the griffin. It's a parchment.
Yeah.
So he just grabs it with the talon and just floats away and flies away into the dark night.
Yeah.
And before you know it, he's gone.
Yeah.
So.
And then I'll just exhaust my spell slots since we're about to rest.
Sure.
So that's when I conjure lightning. Catch the druid's attention.
Oh, if you conjure lightning, your griffin will disappear.
Oh, never mind.
It's concentration up to 1 hour.
Right, I'll wait for an hour then I'll conjure lightning.
And hope that the griffin is fine.
Yeah.
He's late.
Okay. So, what, other than that, what would you guys like to do?
I'm gonna read my book again.
What does not require?
I'm reading my book.
Alright.
Oh my god! The journal. I'm on chapter 6.
Have you read chapter 6 or are you reading chapter 6?
Reading chapter 6. It's called Peace.
You're reading chapter 6. Okay. The warriors stayed and helped peace throughout the land. They had helped build the Evan into a great city. Before they all had returned to their homes, the girl, inheriting Sindriel's visions and knowledge, had been made as a high priestess to Evan. That's all.
That's peace.
Ah, fuck. It's concentration.
Anything else you'd like to do today?
How long has it been?
You guys have settled in for about a couple of hours now.
couple of hours. Okay, now let's conjure lightning.
Huge streaks of lightning begin to settle upon the city of Laramir itself. Go ahead and make a charisma saving throw.
16
Josh.
Saving throw. 20.
20.
Mm.
Okay. It lasts for the better part of an hour.
Mm.
The conjure lightning.
Yeah.
But other than that, no rain fell.
Yeah.
It was a pretty odd spectacle of weather.
Yeah.
On a night where there's a bit of gloom that hangs over the city of Laramir, upon hearing news of the death of a very, very well respected mining head.
Well respected.
Yes, indeed. Anything else you guys would like to do before you start your long rest?
I'm gonna look for around the house to see if there's any metal.
Hmm?
If there's any steel or mithril around this house.
Steel or mithril? Steel or mithril. Alright. Go ahead and make two checks, one for investigation and one for wisdom.
Investigation is 20.
Alright.
Not natural. Wisdom. Wisdom?
Mm-hmm. Straight wisdom.
Wisdom is 17.
17. No straight blocks of cubes or of steel. Nothing far upright, but there are a few irons. And when it comes to mithril, not really. No. There's a lot of metal in here, but...
I'm inspecting door knobs, aren't I?
But most of the stuff inside this house is not made of steel, it's made of iron.
Okay.
Mm.
Well, that's useless. Going back to my room then.
Right.
Ooh! And I'm gonna put the birdcage and ask Fafnir to just put that in our storage.
Okay.
Hand me soon.
Right, so when you take the birdcage, it's... And Fafnir attempts to open it, attempts to just put it inside the... what do you call this?
Chest?
The chest of folding. It doesn't fit.
Ooh. Oh no!
It's a little too big. He might have to just force it in, just to bend the metal just a little bit, just to kind of push it in.
Wait! What good is a cage if it's not... If it's broken. If the gate's broken. Is it broken?
No, it doesn't appear to be broken.
But it does fit?
It is bending a little bit. It's like this big.
Mm-hmm.
And the chest is only like this big.
Oh. That's
so,
not...
he's trying to just jam it in.
Okay, and I stop him.
Hmm.
Stop! Oh, you know what? But I can carry it, right? I can carry it fine?
Sure.
Okay, I'm gonna sell this. Yeah, I'm just gonna keep it in my storage for a bit.
Hmm.
You're gonna sell it 3 more tomorrow?
No. Anyone but him. Yeah. I'll do this tomorrow.
Alright. So the night passes, pretty much without incident. But throughout the night, you do still hear sounds of bells.
Bells.
That ring throughout the town, every or so hour.
Ding, 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 ding.
Go ahead, both of you make a perception roll with that with disadvantage. I'll make the same for effect here.
20.
With disadvantage?
Yeah.
Right.
That would be.
But it's not natural.
Sure.
That would be 8 for me.
8. Okay. As morning arrives, you hear that. It's very faint, but Ariel, you do awaken to that sound. You hurriedly head down the stairs out of your room, and you open the door. It's Renziel. Good morning, Ariel.
Good morning?
Yeah, it's pretty much around 7 a.m.
Okay.
He has a worried look on his face. Not as confident as you remember him, but I thought you were gone. The others, they said you fell into a hole.
So did Bronn.
Well, we found him.
Oh, he's alive.
Where have you been?
Larimer.
In the city?
Yes. Someone found me. I've been here ever since.
He starts frowning a little. Who? Who found you?
I don't remember. Does he believe me?
Insight check. He's inciting check you. But he's just gonna have to take your word for it. He does look a little bit distressed. Do you know anything about what's happening now?
What do you mean, what's happening now?
There's a big ruckus about some murder.
Murder? I don't know what's going on. We heard about it last night at the bar. We were waiting for you. But we were told to head back home.
So, gives you a lot of eye contact.
Yeah. Continues not to blink. Yes, so, I was wondering.
Hold on. You're lying to me.
What? Are you awake yet?
Ariel, just like, crouches over. Tell me the truth.
What do you mean? I've been in there, man.
I can already see what you've done.
What have I done?
She just, like, kind of just attempts to touch your forehead.
Yeah.
And feels.
Back away. And back away.
Right.
Like, ugh.
And just fails to touch you as you backed away.
What are you doing?
I've seen it before. Give me your staff.
No.
Ariel, give me your staff.
It's not yours.
I want to see it.
It's upstairs and you're not allowed to go inside.
You've been corrupted. He looks down with disappointment.
My father's dead.
Don't change the subject.
My father's dead. That's more important right now. He got killed on the way to Valdai. I was told to meet you instead of saving him. Now my father's dead. Because...
I've already told you. Your father's not my concern.
And my mother is.
Your grandfather left me to teach you. But now you've gone missing for the last few days. Your skin's pale, your eyes.
The only reason I've gone missing is because I fell into a huge chasm. Because...
Into the Underdark.
Because of the trials. That you sent us to do.
He kind of just gives this big sigh. Have you taken the dark ritual?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Have you seen him?
You've
met him.
I don't know what you're talking
about. Ariel, I can't do this anymore. I can't do this again. Have you seen him?
I forgot his name as well. Arwen. Is that Arwen?
Is he talking about the monster or Armin? The drow?
I think it's a drow in it. Yeah. That depends who you're referring to.
You know full well who I'm talking about.
Well, I've met a lot of people here.
Perhaps it was a mistake coming here.
Why did I want to meet him again? I forgot.
Sort of turns away. And I can't play another part in this. Goodbye, Ariel.
What, can't the druids help?
He's turned his back on you?
Mm.
And
if not for me, then for the safety of the realm, do you not know what Ilithia is doing?
You kind of have to scream out at this point.
Ilithia's taken over House Rose! She's gonna rule Ironhaven and probably the rest of the kingdom.
He's gone to you. He's just walked away. He's not listening.
Maybe I'll contact the other druids.
And I come down.
Yeah.
Jeez, Ariel, what's going on? Why are you screaming by yourself in the morning?
No, I was just Raziel. He dropped by.
Oh! Is he here?
He's way over there.
Oh, so I ran down the stairs and tried to look at his silhouette. Oh, that person?
Have you seen him around?
You barely see a speck in the horizon now at this point.
Can't recall. We've only met him once. So.
Yeah.
No, Oh, he's gone. No, can't tell who that was. That was your master then? Why were you screaming at him?
He did not help.
Why? I thought he was supposed
to
be a good person.
What's going on here?
Hello, Martha.
Hello. Yeah.
Why are you still wearing the hat?
I like the way I look. Martha's very pretty.
Would you like to change? Would you like to be another person today? I think having a male companion would keep us safer.
Fafnir can do that. Where's the card?
It's with him.
Alright.
But it only, it's the same thing as my warlock now.
Okay.
Cast it.
Without. Kind of just takes off the hat for a while.
Oh, there he is again.
Instantly, the illusion wears off and turns into a dragon.
Ah, much better.
Fafnir will think about it.
Alright. Well, you better keep that thing safe. We've killed someone for it. If not gonna use it, give it back to me. And I'll sell it to someone. Speaking of which, I'm about to sell my cage, but
I can call Mortimer if you want.
No! You were there! I stole this thing!
Oh, you stole it!
Well, I took it.
I didn't think you'd use that word.
Well,
steal is such a strong word.
Oh, okay. He couldn't have used it last night because he wasn't attuned.
Wasn't attuned.
That's why he became Martha. That's why he became Martha.
Yeah. Not enough attunement.
Yeah.
Well,
the staff is attuned to me, Sibel.
Yeah.
After long rest,
we attuned it together. So, do you still want to meet those druids, or do we still should we go to straight to Ironhaven then? I think I'll have a better time selling this in Ironhaven.
I think I need to see my brother.
Peter?
Yeah.
Are you ready?
Is there ever a right time to tell my little brother that I'm still alive?
I guess you're right. Beats me telling them.
It's true.
Okay. How far is it? A week?
It'll take about a week if you travel by conventional means.
What about the underground?
The underground tunnel will probably take you within 2 days.
Yeah. I know a quick way to get to Ironhaven.
Oh! Is that safe?
It was relatively safe when we used it to get to here from Valadai. I mean, that's what we used.
Alright, I'll take your word for it. And, we're going now?
Oh, I can't convince
the druids. Maybe it's faster than it'll ever be.
Right. Can I ask help from the druids?
Hey, Fafnir.
Yes, Isabel.
Do you mind carrying this for me? Since it doesn't fit the cage, chest.
Alright.
Are you sure?
What is a cage?
Well, this thing.
It doesn't look heavy.
Okay, well, you know what, maybe I'll help you tie this onto the chest, maybe.
Alright.
Is that possible?
How would you do that? On top of his haversack, there's this huge stone chest.
Mm-hmm.
That pretty much acts as a headrest for him now.
Okay.
And now you're going to tie another birdcage on top of it.
He's
pretty much going to be 7.5 feet tall at this point.
Does it fit though? Does he want to do it?
He already said yes.
Okay.
Wow.
In that case.
Yes, man.
Yes, man. I'll try to... Oh, hey, Ariel. Do you think this house is a rope?
You can use whatever you want.
Okay. And I'll try to, like... Oh, I did investigate the house last night. Did I find a rope?
Not rope,
like,
per se. You did see some curtain ropes.
Okay.
That were used to tie some of the house curtains.
Hey, you don't need these, right?
Just take them.
Okay.
Can I find, like, noble clothes?
Oh yeah, you definitely have some noble clothes in your bedroom.
Just stuff them in my sack and actually wear one of them.
So you have 3 sets of noble clothing.
Yeah.
The color, I'll leave that up to you. Just write that down.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Are you donning it now?
I'm gonna wear one.
Okay.
But
your pig cloak is still with us.
Okay. My pig cloak. Okay.
I'll just say that I'm the one who kept it.
Yeah. So I'm wearing noble clothes.
Don't you look fancy and dandy? Do you have any more of those?
You can check the handmaiden's room.
Oh.
The handmaidens are quite fancy as well.
Oh, really?
Slightly.
Wait, why do I need clothes anyway? I can disguise myself.
Would you like to take some of the clothes instead? Actually, I would like some handmaiden clothes too.
Okay.
How many sets?
You head over to the handmaidens' quarters. They do have 2 sets of handmaidens' uniform, specifically for the house rose.
Yeah,
it's like this—a very navy blue handmade clothes with a very puffy lace that kind of like covers the neck.
Okay.
Well, you've beat me to it, so.
Would you like one? There's two.
Sure.
Okay, so I'll
I can
have
always
one.
Use another disguise.
One set of handmaiden. Who knows, you might need it.
Yeah.
Is it... Are we carrying too many stuff already?
No, there's the chest, the folding.
Let me know when you guys reach 10.
10 what?
10 items.
Oh.
10 extra items left.
10 extra items.
Okay. I have 3, 4.
Let's put that in a tray.
Including your weapons. Your new weapons and stuff.
But,
so 2 questions.
If I'm wearing the chain shirt, doesn't that mean it's not in the bag?
It's not in the bag.
Okay.
But you probably had to swap out something
mm.
for it.
I can sell the frost one, Ben. I still have it.
Oh, you haven't used it?
From the first episode. Oh, no, no, second.
That might help for another one. Or any fire.
Yeah.
Things.
Do that.
Because I don't have any ice magic. Well, we have a dragon who can breathe
ice,
but he doesn't.
Would have been useful for the fire elemental, just pointing that out.
Yeah, if he remembers to say it, to breathe out.
Oh, I have Lizzle Gauntlet still. I could have sold it.
Lizzle Gauntlet adds your strength, I believe. Or AC or defense.
Okay. Right, I've got space. 5.
I took Ermin's head, by the way. What does that look like?
Ermin's head.
Hat.
Hat. Oh, he had a hat?
Yeah, you said I took his hat and his sword. His sword was the flame tongue.
Oh, Ermin.
Ermin. Arman? Ermin. No, Ermin.
Yeah, it pretty much almost looks like the hat of disguise, but it's just a regular hat.
So it's just disguised.
It's one of those full brim hats.
Yeah.
Right. So after you settle out the birdcage, are you guys setting off?
He looks so tall.
Or short. Because there's so many tall things in front of him. Behind him.
Ah, that's true. That's very true.
What color is his cloak?
Cloak?
Yeah, him.
Fafnir, probably?
Yeah.
It's black. A very metallic black cloak.
Alright.
What are you thinking?
No, I was gonna loot to my house, but never mind.
Oh, okay.
Right. Shall we get going?
I guess so.
Do I know where the underrealm is?
You exited from it the night before.
Okay.
So you probably have an idea.
Okay. Right.
Even if you don't,
I remember. I remember the entrance down, but afterwards I do not know where to go.
Okay.
I only know how to get to the Brotherhood's halls there.
Alright. So it'll take you guys the better part of 20 minutes, but before you head out, Fafnir puts on his hat.
Mm.
Turns into this very very young mid-30s gentleman with a very long, pointy beard.
Yeah.
Which... It's funny, it plays kind of like an illusion. If you kind of look to your left, it kind of looks like a snout.
That's nice.
But more or less, this dark-haired, pointy-bearded gentleman.
Not bad.
With a very thick mustache.
Ah, bonjour, monsieur.
Hello.
Oui, I will teach you more of the act of acting.
Yeah, as a matter of fact, he does look a little less stoic. So,
shall we go then?
The better part of 20 minutes, you guys head on down the streets. A little bit more hushed and whispered, because people are looking like back and forth. Like, you can sort of hear rumors. Like, I heard that the mining guy was dead. Like, yeah, they got the killer. Yeah. And then, like, at one point, you even hear, I can't believe it was Markov. But nonetheless, you head.
Poker face.
You head downwards towards the underground and into that main terminal hall that you've been to 3 times, once before for Ariel. And yeah, there you go.
Well, here we are. I don't know where else to go after this.
The terminal is slightly as busy as ever, as opposed to upstairs, however.
Mm-hmm.
Again, there are 6 tunnels on either side of this hall, all interconnected to some form of place. But with a quick look at some maps and directions, you manage to find the 3rd tunnel on the right does lead to where it's Ironhaven.
There's a label?
Yeah, as labeled.
Oh, wow.
Ironhaven.
Ah!
Mm.
Well spotted.
It's a very huge sign.
Yes.
It's a very huge cave. Tunnel.
It's a tunnel. You head in towards the tunnel, and for the better part of about 5 minutes, you kind of just realize that it's a spiraling down tunnel.
Mm.
Kind of leads into more connected tunnels.
Mm.
But as you reach the under part of it, you sort of see this very large slab of rock that's placed on some form of tunnel network in front of a tunnel. And while there's not a lot of people per se down here, you do see a couple of people, including one sort of very sharply dressed man, humanoid. He's a little furry. He's got like a very bulbous nose. It's kind of like the nose of a cow. It's kind of gray fur skin and sort of like looks at the two of you and goes, good morning. Are you guys headed to Ironhaven?
Yes.
Alright, that'll be 5 copper each.
Oh, very well.
May I just ask, what are you?
I'm a conductor, if that's what you're asking.
Oh. And,
You're a cute little one, and just, like, scruffles up your head.
What race are you?
Well, go ahead and make an intelligence check, both of you. Both of you have heard of it. You've probably seen it in the south. It's a firbolg. Sort of like a very canine-like creature, but not so canine, with not so canine features.
Firbolg.
Firbolg.
Is that, how do you spell
that? That's F-I-R. B-O-L-G.
I see. Now stop playing with my hair.
I'm sorry, dear. How about you guys have a seat, and we'll wait for the others to show up.
Very well. Ooh, it's like a shuttle system.
We'll leave in about 3 minutes.
Wow.
Get yourself settled.
Okay.
It's gonna be a long 2 days.
Pass him the money.
Alright, 5 copper each.
5 copper. It's so cheap.
Shit. You settle down into this large stone slab with like some wooden benches sat around. As a matter of fact, if the closer you are towards the front, you kind of feel this arcanic aura.
Mm.
You felt this feeling before. But you just can't put your head to it.
Hmm.
Yeah.
For me?
Both of you actually have felt this feeling before.
What? When you were transported?
Oh!
Feels somewhat familiar.
About 2 or 3 minutes passed, and while a few humans do join you, 3 other humanoids grab your attention. As a matter of fact, they grab everyone's attention whenever they walk around. But you see these, again, very tall, muscular humanoids. There's 2 female and there's 1 large male. Both females have like whitish hair, with some dark black highlights, and this male is bald.
Okay.
Very, very strong features. Very grayish skin as well. All 3 of them. They board the platform onto you, and while the male notices both of you, they don't really acknowledge you, but keep a distance and just sit at one of the benches for now. The Firbolg goes ahead and announces, "All aboard, heading to Arnhaven."
2 days.
2 days journey.
Wow.
Have a nice nap. And you go. The platform just begins to start moving. It kind of lifts off the ground a little bit and starts to move and hover.
Mm.
And proceeds towards the tunnel. This is your arcane train. This is the best I can come up with, guys.
Okay. It's pretty cool.
It moves along the tunnel. First at a very slow speed. And before you know it, a breakneck speed and just begins to just whoosh through the tunnel.
Oh god, how is this trip so cheap? It's ridiculous.
And as that happens, towards the front right corner, a kind of bar situation just starts to pop up. So it becomes like a mini tavern on the corner.
Ooh.
And wouldn't you know it, it's the same Firbolg. And like, well, bar is open, guys. If you'd like anything, just come on over.
Do you recognize those 2 people? I take a look. They're staring.
There's 3 of them.
Yeah.
Both ladies are not.
Mm-hmm.
But the guy. Once you stare at him, he escapes your stare. You caught him like staring at you for a bit, and then he just looks away.
No, I don't. What are they like? Are they like Goliath like, or just really huge humanoids?
They're very huge humanoids. They're not Goliaths per se. They're a bit more fitter looking, they're a bit more smaller.
Mm-hmm.
But still
grayish.
quite tall.
Okay. Do they have the same complexion as her now?
No,
she's just pale.
No, she's just pale, but those 3, they're very grayish.
Okay. No, I don't. But I'm gonna stay here for 2 days with them, so we might as well be friendly, huh?
Yes. Good day.
Oh, you walk up to the
3
of them?
Good day.
The man looks at you and the other two are a bit more colder.
So I've noticed you staring at my friend.
Are you talking to me?
Yes.
I do not know what you're talking about.
Do you often stare at people that way?
I do not know what you're talking about. And the lady next to him just like smacks him at the back of the head.
Ooh.
And he goes, don't talk to him.
I just keep
do
looking.
Not know what you're talking about. Kind of just situation kind of looking. But as he says that, he does make one last glimpse at Isabel.
Fafnir, what's going on here?
Fafnir's not with you guys. He has escaped to the bar.
Okay.
Enjoying a drink as a middle-aged man.
Can I just try to recall if I've met him?
Sure.
Because he sounds like he knows me. Looks like he knows me.
What was that? It's a wisdom check.
Eighteen.
Mm. Okay. Vaguely familiar. Can't put your head. You can't put your finger on it. But maybe he's seen one of your performances.
Okay. I put my hand out to shake one of the lady's hands.
My name's Sasha. And you are?
The lady in the middle has her hands folded and looks at you.
Is it just us, by the way, in this?
There's a couple of humans who've made a trip with you.
Mm-hmm.
Other than the three of you, the three of them, these two humans, and the frog.
Oh, okay. It's very nice to meet you too. I'm gonna walk away.
Do you know them?
I don't. I was trying to get to know them. I'm not that friendly.
Oh. Well, okay. We'll see what it's like later. Shall we join Fafnir at the bar?
Yes, I would like some ale.
Looks at the guy again.
They do seem a bit suspicious. Do you know what race they are?
Do I? Well, I've seen so many races, I don't usually ask.
To you, they just look like really pale humans.
Some pale humans.
They're pretty big humans.
Fit too. Are they wearing clothes?
Yeah, they're wearing like sleeveless like leather armor.
All
of them. The two ladies are pretty striking. In fact, if you look closer, they are in fact twins. They're wearing like very black lipstick, kind of very goth looking, as a matter of fact.
I'm so curious. Okay. I take a chug of ale. A mug of ale.
That'll be 10 gold.
Oh, take 10 gold.
10 gold! That's ridiculous, Firbolg!
Well, we get you at the ticket prices, and we get you at the ale.
That's smart. I like
Would you like some sausages?
Oh, no,
they're
thank
only 50
you.
Gold pieces each.
Okay, 10 gold.
What meat are they?
Oh, just some cow.
This is pretty strong ale. I can see why it's 10 gold.
Oh, is it?
That's really strong.
Go ahead, make a constitution saving throw.
What color is it?
The sausages or the ale?
The ale.
It was a very strong orange.
11.
Pinkish orange. 11?
Mm.
Yeah, you are drunk.
Oh boy.
That.
A little tipsy, yeah.
That gray buff guy is still staring at you. He's got a crush on you.
Huh?
And I look. Is he still looking at me?
No.
Okay.
He's looked down now.
Mm.
Like, once in a while you can see, like, the girl in the middle is just, like, giving him a bit of lip.
Mm. What?
A bit of, like, a talking to.
Oh.
Mm. Do you think that triplet said it the same?
No idea.
Out of all the people on this train, they seem the most suspicious.
Suspicious? What did they say to you then?
No, they were just staring at you. Or us.
I think it was you.
Fafnir, what do you think?
This is good ale.
Fafnir, would you like to accompany me to talk with them?
Like, Fruble,
yes.
How many ales does my friend have?
Oh, it's been a good 40 gold.
Four?
Oh,
yep. As many as he wants.
Oh, gosh.
I don't know. Fafnir, let's go.
Yes, that will be a good idea.
Say, you. I approach the
three
people.
Alright.
What race are you? You don't look you. You don't look like a good ass. But you're grey.
The one in the middle still gives you that bitch face. But the one on the far right just isn't really looking at you.
Mm.
Has her hand on one of the handles, her elbow on the handles. Just closer. Never heard of Asimov?
Asimov? No, unfortunately, I've been living in the forest for a while. What is Asimov?
How nice of you.
Yes. See, I'm not very civil.
They can't tell the difference because they don't have their wings.
Hmm.
So. Did they get to hide it?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay.
What's Asimov?
Winged human.
Oh.
Not really winged humans. Go ahead, both of you, make a history check.
Okay.
So I can tell you.
Well.
Natural 20!
Okay. Ooh, history. But I don't know that he's an Asimov, though. I wasn't there.
Okay.
I'm still there.
So, Ariel, natural 20,
mm-hmm.
You know the Asimov to be a mixed race of human and celestial.
Ooh!
So they have a tendency to carry on celestial traits into their human form.
Mm.
They're not known to be the most sociable,
mm.
Because they carry their celestial trait.
Mm.
They have a inferiority complex towards celestials and superiority complex towards humans.
Mm.
So this, the one on the far edge, just after that dry comment,
mm.
just stays quiet.
Yeah. Oh,
the
wait.
One in the middle is still giving you a bitch face look.
Okay.
Ah, oh, yes. Half human, half celestial. I'm half human and half high elf. Very nice to meet you.
The male puts out his hand.
Mm.
And as he does, the girl in the middle just grabs the hand, puts it back.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go up to them now and what's Fafnir doing? Just standing by?
Mm-hmm. Fafnir looks a little woozy.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I'm sorry. Is my friend, is she disturbing you?
Did she know they're assholes?
Ah!
No wonder they look pretty smug right now.
Oh, don't call them that. I'm like, oh, I'm so sorry. And then, like, I'll try to pull the two of them. We'll leave you guys alone.
Well, I mean, I thought high elves were smug. I didn't know celestials were even worse.
Well, like, once I'm closer, can I see what this guy looks like? Is his facial features complimentary?
Well...
Or is it...
Not a bad-looking guy. He's got a very strong face to him. Very, very muscular, very... he's bald, and he's got a very strong brow kind of situation.
How is he, Grog?
No.
Okay. Good looking.
No beard, no mustache. It's just a very clean face.
Okay.
Mm.
Is Is he like Bruce Willis?
I'm just kidding.
Well, if you want him to be, I mean, I don't see why not.
Yeah, it's weird. Yeah, well, I was saying that I'll give them like a good look in the face and try to see that, are they really twins or are they triplets? And then as I make eye contact with the guy, like I'll give him a wink and then I'll like pull my two friends away back to our seats.
Hmm. You gather that they might be triplets, but you can't really tell. They do seem to be a very a close-knit group of three people. So you could gather, they could be siblings. As you kind of bend over just to meet his gaze, and you just give him a wink as you like push away. So he goes, his gray complexion turns a little pink. But nevertheless, just looks away.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Say, since we have 2 days, do you think we have time to perform on this?
Next up, Iron Maiden.
What? It's been 2 days.
And as you do, you kind of exit this tunnel kind of situation. And for a short moment, you see Ironhaven's mountain tops and buildings that have been kind of built along the base of the hill. And before it descends back into the tunnel. And within the next 5 minutes, you arrive at some sort of underground station. Kind of the same situation with the Undercity in Laramir.
Mm. Well, I thought it was going to take 2 days.
The Asimar would be the first people to stand up and just line up in a row, ready to leave the station at this point.
Mm.
The humans
it's
are still
2 days,
set down.
5 minutes for these people.
Yeah.
Maybe it's like arcane, so we don't feel like it's 2 days.
Maybe. I don't think it's possible.
Mm. Go ahead. Arcana check.
Okay.
Fifteen. Yeah. Isabel, you gathered that 2 days have actually passed because you see a very large calendar outside of the station that kind of depicts it's been 2 days.
Oh,
that's ridiculous.
Ariel, you know it's been 2 days because of your druidic abilities.
Mm.
Like,
but you were just drunk.
You didn't really say anything.
Yeah.
But you felt like time passed.
Quick.
Mm. Yikes. So how old is Firbolg?
That's true.
That is very interesting.
See you around, ladies.
Goodbye.
And just tries to attempt to kind of like get your head.
Right.
You swat him away and it's like, geez, you're cute.
Is he drunk?
Hmm?
I guess he's like cat ears or something.
Oh, well, since you're a nice guy, here, have my card.
It's been a while.
Alright, go ahead and expend one card.
Expend one card.
So, you arrive at this very unfamiliar station area. For area, you don't really remember seeing this part of the station, this part of the city or anything. But alas, you make your way up, ascend upon the stairs, and before you know it, you are in the very, very deep southern part of Ironhaven.
Mm.
Hey, look, I finally got to use this map.
Ironhaven!
So, Ariel, you will have the advantage of knowing the city.
Yeah.
So you are in the southwestern part of the city.
Mm.
Just a little background on what Ironhaven is. Ironhaven is pretty much a trading town, mining town.
Mm.
They specialize in several different types of ore, especially... Oh, sorry. Let me just go look it up. Especially famous for producing copper diamonds.
Mm.
Black diamonds, as a matter of fact, which are pretty rare.
Mm.
And especially now, they are especially famous for mining anthracite. It's a certain type of coal which is used for stoking fire, for forging what you know, what everyone knows to be adamantium, which is known to be the hardest metal in the world.
Yeah.
And it's only forged here by the dwarven companies. There is a large road that crosses the entire half of Ironhaven, which is known as the travel, known as Trader's Road.
Mm.
This road is a direct connection from Valadai all the way to West Haven, which is the city next to Ironhaven. You are now in the southern part of Ironhaven, which is known to be more the lower sections of the city.
Yeah.
This area would be known as the Merchant District. There are several bridges that cross above the Traveler's Road, and that would head up to the northern part of the area, which is known as the Noble District.
Mm.
So, you find yourself home for the first time in probably a year and a half. What is your first instinct?
Nothing's changed.
Mm.
Merchant. Oh yeah, I hang out around merchant.
Yes, as a matter of fact. You have a tendency to kind of stay at Enid's house, which is located in the Southern District.
Mm.
The street is quite familiar to you.
Yeah.
Hey.
Southwest.
Yep.
Ding, ding,
I'll let you dictate
ding, ding,
where you are right now,
ding, ding,
because you,
ding, ding,
you know
ding,
the city
ding,
more than we do.
Ding, ding, ding,
there.
There.
Okay.
This is the Merchants District, southwest of Ironhaven. Ooh, perfect! Yes, I think you can sell your cage here.
Mm-hmm.
That would be a good idea.
Oh, are you sober now?
I don't think...
How are you feeling, Fafnir?
Not very well.
I think...
Is he gonna constitution save himself?
Here did he roll a 5.
Yeah.
Oh, no, that's fine. Wait, do I have to? 16.
You sort of sobered up.
Mm.
But I think Fafnir is drunk a little bit too much.
Yeah.
Visibly... in mental distress.
Mm. Maybe I should have had some of those 10 gold ale.
They're pretty nice.
Well, good. I get why it has to be that strong. It has to stay for 2 days.
Mm. Yeah.
It's kind of crazy.
Mm.
What?
I want to change from noble clothing to handmaiden's clothes so I don't catch attention.
Which is very good, as so you kind of like head into a back alley situation.
Yeah. Yeah.
Just try to change into handmaiden's clothes. Because as you did, you notice everyone's favorite patrol guards, the gold cloaks, have been patrolling the cities.
Mm-hmm.
A little bit more than you usually remember.
Mm.
They don't usually hang around the merchant's district that much, but
yeah.
Somehow on this day.
Yeah.
Let's see. Now, how do we get to your house?
After we go through the merchant's
town, buildings, many buildings.
This area right here would be for the noble houses.
Oh, far up north.
Yeah. And, yeah, this particular street is known to be the area where the noble houses and the house of the Lord Governor would reside.
Mm.
This particular road is just a winding road that kind of winds up into the base of the mountains, which kind of leads to the dwarven caves, the dwarven mining caves, which is known as the Grimdawn Caves. At this point, you've turned into a handmaiden, Isabel and Fafnir. Anything else?
I'm looking around to see if I could gauge how the people in Ironhaven dress.
Right.
And keep that in mind.
Okay. Well, in this part of the area, more of the middle class and some of the lower class traders. They're just walking, doing about their daily business. A lot of hues of white and blue. Blue seems to be a running color in Ironhaven.
I see.
And as you realize that the national flag of Ironhaven is just blue and a bit of grays and whites, and it has a picture of the Ironhaven Mountain that's in the background, and a picture of two large hammers. It's the better part of early morning, about 7 to 8 a.m. You guys just make your way around town, I guess, but is there anything in particular you're going towards or looking for?
Well, I still need to find Mr. Lord Steel, and I also want to sell the cage.
Okay.
And I think this is the best place to sell it, probably.
Okay.
I'm just gonna gauge which is the best place to sell.
Alright. Investigation check for you.
Just her?
Well, what are you doing?
Even worse.
Seven.
Seven?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Five.
Not used to this. So many changes.
Actually, Ariel would know
of
the whereabouts of everything.
Okay.
You've heard of a blacksmith / weapon shop.
Yeah.
Calls himself the Mighty Mace.
Mm.
There's a human there who runs the shop. His name's Gamel. Eric's talked about him for a couple of times.
Yeah.
Hang on. I think I remember a place called Mighty Mace across the road.
Lead the way.
Eric's talked about him.
Do you think he's here?
Mm-hmm. Eric. Oh.
Eric.
I don't know.
Your boyfriend. One of these days they'll come true.
Moving on.
Right. So you move on towards across the street and around the corner, and you recall the Mighty Mace. As a matter of fact, you have been here before. You were just not that interested before. It is more of an open shop situation, and as you do, you kind of see a huge anvil. And like a very typical, like, burly human being, just hammering away.
Ding, 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 ding.
Yeah.
And I go in and ask this burly man, good morning, monsieur.
Monsieur.
Just opens up his goggles.
Black suit on.
With a little black suit all over. Just his eyes, like beady eyes.
Yes, good morning. Sorry for taking your time, but would you like to purchase my magic cage?
What's a magic cage?
Oh, you don't know anything about a magic cage?
What magic cage?
Oh, well, that over there, and I'll get Fafnir to come.
That's a statue.
No, not him. And I take it down.
All right.
This cage right here.
Oh, yeah, yes. take a look at that.
It's
just kind of like inspecting all over the place.
It's an anti-magic cage.
A what?
An anti-magic cage.
Magic cage?
Anti-magic cage. Even better. You can trap anything inside and they won't leave. If they are magical.
Go ahead and make a persuasion roll. I don't really see anything.
Do you like
magical
to catch any fairies? No, of course not. Shit.
Persuasion.
Mm-hmm.
17.
17?
Yeah.
It's got good iron. Where'd you get this from?
During my travels, I just came upon it.
Oh.
Shall I?
Stolen?
No.
Because that's a reduction in price.
No, it's not. I found it.
Oh.
Legally.
It's steel, iron. Very good.
Mm-hmm.
Very good.
Let me show you, and then I'll like conjure up the Yori.
Mm-hmm. Alright.
This here.
Whoa!
What?
You just grab the hammer and just starts like
banging
the ground.
Don't worry, it's
Yori
familiar.
Begins just dodging.
It's so familiar.
What is this magic?
Well, you know what, Ariel? I don't think he's the right person for this.
Oh, no,
I mean, Saoirse.
Hi, I'm Enid's apprentice. I believe you know her.
I'm gonna take back the cage before he wrecks it. Sorry,
you look sort of familiar.
Yes.
You hang around this area a lot.
Yes, I do.
I never forget a face. So, what did you want to do with this?
Never mind. Give that back to me.
Alright.
But would you happen to sell any good metals here, such as steel or any mithril?
Oh, we've got a few. Copper?
No.
Iron then.
Mm-mm.
I mean, Iron Haven. Full of iron. Yeah, wouldn't you know it?
Yes, I understand that, but I'm not looking for any iron. I need a higher grade than that.
What kind of grade?
I already told you. Steel or mithril.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
Well, mithril. I may have a few.
Alright.
What do you need it for? Not to build another cage, I suspect.
That could be in the list, but no.
Well, usually what we do is we have the steel and build something for you, but I've never had a situation where I had to sell my raw materials.
I only need about a pound. Just a pound, right?
A pound?
Just a pound for the bracer.
Alright. Don't remember. I'm just checking.
Because I don't need much.
A cubic block.
A cubic block.
Yeah, so it's about a pound, I'd say.
Okay. Yes, only a pound, please.
Okay, why don't you give me a few minutes here? Have a look around. Maybe you find something you like.
Okay. It's a weapon shop.
Takes one more glance at that cat. And goes on.
My dog's still in there.
But at least he's free to be the wolf that he is.
Yeah. Or I can just call
the griffin to pick him up.
Actually, I want to do that.
You're listening. What am I doing here? Why'd you call me up again?
You're a pet. I don't understand, though.
You familiar?
Would he be talking to you telepathically?
Yes.
Yeah.
But he can move his mouth if he wants to.
Sure. You're a pet. You see that cage? That's for you.
Oh, right. It's here.
Like, flies away.
All right.
I'm out of here.
I'm gonna call a griffin outside.
Oh, okay.
What?
Call a griffin. Again, conjure a griffin.
In Ironhaven?
And the back alley.
Okay.
Yeah.
The griffin begins perching up on this very, very shambling kind of structure, which is the blacksmith's area.
Yeah.
Just whoa, whoa, whoa! Are we under attack? He just kind of looks up. Wow! Kind of grabs a little bit more attention than should. People start looking in and kind of see this huge griffin and begin starting making their paces back carefully.
Ariel, what are you doing?
I think I want Doggo back. It'll take a few days.
Oh,
a few hours. Seeing as the griffin's quite big.
Okay.
Huh.
Well, I thought you didn't want to draw any attention to us.
This happens a lot. I mean, there's a circus over there. Right? There's a rush to grace for this.
Rushed. So,
what is this town?
With a bit of instruction, the griffin floats off away. And like a bit of like, like among the crowd, just kind of like talking. That was
darn circus freaks. You yelling?
Interesting. Oh, anyway, did you say a pound?
Yes.
It's actually 5 pounds of steel here. Would you like to take that? I charge you. But I don't think you'd want that, to cut it.
Why not?
Well, I could probably do it for you, but I'm a little busy.
I see.
Do you have any magic that can cut metal?
No, I don't.
Heat metal.
Well, there's flame blade. But it won't be clean cut.
Yeah, and then he'll be like, oh, my merchandise.
Steel, did you say?
Steel or mithril?
I think you want the steel. Mithril's a little expensive.
How much?
Well, usually it'll go for about 2,500 gold pieces.
That's ridiculous! For a piece? For a pound?
For a pound. I guess it was a little stupid of me to assume. Yeah, I mean, it's 4 gold pieces for a pound of steel.
Ooh.
It's what?
It's 4 gold pieces for a pound of steel.
Wow. That difference is crazy.
The ale is more expensive, though.
The what?
The ale.
A pound of steel would be just like a ball of steel.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But the mithril is finer.
The mithril is finer. It does have a higher AC.
Oh. Does it?
And it's a bit lighter, right?
Yes.
It has a higher AC. Does that mean if I get a mithril, this will be not plus 2?
If you used it as a regular bracers of defense, it would have given you a plus 2. If it was a steel bracers of defense, it would have given your AC to 19.
Steel is plus 2.
AC 19.
All straight to 19. And then mithril?
Mithril will get it down to 20.
What?
Not worth it.
Not worth it?
Because for the plus 1, which is 2,000.
It's very true.
I mean, you can eventually build it up.
Yeah, okay. Well. Alright, it might make sense. I am not made of gold. Give me that pound of steel, please.
Alright, here we go. And, any other pieces of gold that you like?
Well,
adamantine, brass, bronze.
No, but, any good weapons around here?
Sure, we always have good weapons around here. We can even make some weapons for you if you want. So what kind of weapons are you looking for?
Was that 4 gold?
4 gold pieces, yes.
wouldn't mind a nice short sword for myself.
Alright. Any short sword in particular? You seem to be interested in magical items.
How do you know?
Well, you tried to sell me a magical gauge for one.
That's very true, that's very true. It says here any sword. So it can be a short sword is sword, right?
Yeah.
I don't want to handle a big sword. How's about this?
What's a young lady like you interested in the short swords?
Why not?
Well, not very ladylike.
Who are you to judge?
I'm a blacksmith.
I bet you don't have a wife.
But I sell a lot of weapons.
Okay. Well, do you want the money or not? I want this pretty gold, this pretty short sword, please.
Alright, just a regular short sword.
Just a short sword.
15 gold pieces.
Alright.
That's a good deal.
Too tired to haggle.
What about you, young lady? Something for the house, or?
I don't require anything.
Alright.
At the moment.
Fair enough. Can I get back to work now?
I believe so.
Alright.
Thanks for your patronage.
No, thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, so after that valuable exchange, anything else you'd guys like to do? Or?
I want to look for Enid's house,
Enid's
she's here.
Alright. You sort of head towards Enid's house.
Mm.
You look out. It appears to be empty at this point. It's still early morning, but not unattended. It does appear to be empty.
Is this whose house is this?
Enid.
Your nanny?
Yes.
Your maid?
Yes. I'll knock on the door.
Alright. No answer.
Hi, this is Sasha.
And as you do, a voice calls out from behind. You're looking for something?
Oh, I'm looking for Enid. Is she around?
And you turn around.
Yeah.
You recognize the man.
Oh.
It's a very short, stubby man.
Yeah.
A very thick mustache. Very grayish mustache. You know him to be Enid's husband.
Mm.
You don't look like Sasha.
Is Enid around?
Wait. He just kind of like looks, hold on to you. Inside, now!
Okay.
Just opens the door. Just closes. The three of you just begin to settle down a little bit. My lady, what are you doing here?
I need to see Peter.
Do you know that there's a bounty on your head?
Yes, I do.
Then why would you come here?
I need to speak with Peter.
Do you realize that you're putting yourself in danger? They will...
I do, but I need to see Peter.
Right.
Where's Enid?
Enid hasn't returned.
From Valadai?
She's been staying there.
For what?
I don't know.
Is Saoirse there as well?
That I don't know.
Then I could pretend to be Saoirse.
Well, as you remember, Saoirse is still in Laramir.
Yeah.
Okay. No! Why did I invite you in? He begins to just start panicking and just heads upstairs for a little bit.
Well, there's a makeup kit. I can try to look different. Maybe put a beauty mark on my face. And freckles.
So it's
or use
down.
The hat.
And like hands you like a piece of parchment.
Yeah.
Which clearly states a 250,000 gold piece reward.
Oh wow.
But
for,
I thought they thought I was dead.
Well, they do, however. The person in charge doesn't.
Mm.
So it's
why would
it's
there
not so much of a wanted dead or alive kind of situation. It is more of a we're looking for Lady Ariel kind of situation.
Yeah.
Oh.
But so people know I'm alive then.
If
Ironhaven.
If you feel like you have to see Peter, then I'll just have to warn you that there has been a change in
yes.
in lordship.
Yes, it's Ilithia. So I've heard.
Yes, the Lady Ilithia has taken over the governor's house.
And
house. Your house. So I can't be much assistance.
Hmm.
But I do hope that you know what you're doing.
I do.
Very well.
Okay.
So, but before he does, Kenan just grabs like a drawer, opens it up, like passes you like 3 or 4 vials. It appears to be just healing potions, just 4 healing potions.
Yay!
Then I will pray for you, my lady.
Thank you. That means a lot.
And if you don't mind, please exit from the back.
Of course.
Thank you, all three of you. Please be careful. There are a lot of gold cloaks hanging around now. I pray I don't hear of your death.
Yes. I pray the same. Okay, before I leave the place, I would like to wear makeup so that I look less like me.
Alright. So you just wear like a beauty mark on
yeah.
on your cheek and stuff.
I'll put a bit more freckles. Wear eyeliner.
Right. Make you look more ginger. All right.
Yeah.
Okay.
Like thicken my eyebrows as well.
All right. You leave out from the back, and you find yourself very, very close to the Traveler's Road at this point in time. You sort of get the gist of what's happening now, and at this point. You sort of kind of realize that everyone is a little bit on edge after meeting with Enid's husband.
Yeah.
The parchment that you just took from him, it has a declaration that Ariel Rose has been missing. And that they are in fact looking for you, offering a 250,000 gold piece reward to be returned to House Rose on Monterey Hill. As you continue out in the streets, you sort of see more bulletins. The bulletins catch more of your eyes now. Like very large pieces of parchment with headlines like saying House Dormer defunct or the end of House Rose, and there are other like particular headlines that catches your eye, like Lady Ilithia now under care under Ironhaven under the care of Ironhaven is Lady Alicia. But the mood still stays the same. It's as if it's just business as usual, as you remember in Ironhaven.
Who are they returning you to, then?
What do you mean?
If we do return you to House Rose, who will be there to welcome you? It would be Alethea, wasn't it?
I'm not going to meet Alethea, I just want to see Peter. I need to find a way to get him out of Alethea's...
But wouldn't Alethea be in the same house as
He would,
as
but
Peter?
It's a pretty big house.
I'm not drunk anymore.
Good to know. But I'm sure she has eyes and ears in the house.
True, but does she have their loyalty?
Do you have their loyalty?
They follow my father and Peter. Let's see if I do still have them.
Just to be safe, do you want to appear as someone else?
Do I not look like I'm someone else?
You've already changed your appearance to
with
a makeup kit. Kind of just have a bushier eyebrows and like a beauty mark and
freckles
on.
Thick eyeliner. So I don't look, you know, like, attractive.
Okay. Can people still discern that it's her?
It'll be difficult.
Mm.
Okay.
I'll have my hair braided like a handmaiden.
Alright, if you say so.
Should I have soot on my face as well? Like a root and a coal.
So you're gonna enter House Rose as a handmaiden?
There are passages, secret passages in the castle I used to use to escape.
And you're gonna try to blend in as one of the handmaidens?
Yes. There would be passages. I can sneak in, but I wouldn't know where Peter would be.
Sounds like a bad idea, but are we doing that now, today?
Yes.
Then...
In the meantime, you could look for places to sell the cage.
Well, that's not important, but... Fafnir, what do you think? Should we enter? No, we probably shouldn't.
Fafnir thinks it's dangerous to go alone.
Well, I know the castle by heart and the passages. No other servants know about it. Just me, Peter, and Eric.
Right. I can assist you inside. Would that be best? Or I could send Yori with you, so we'll have direct connections all the time, communications all the time. But
that's possible. Oh, I can turn to an animal for a bit. I can turn to a cat.
Are you level 8 now?
Yeah.
Yes.
We can turn to a bird now, you can
try. No, she's a level 7 druid.
Okay.
I can turn into a cat so I can roam around the house.
Mm-hmm.
You could.
Yeah.
But just in case, I'll have Yori walk around, fly around with you.
Yeah. Right. Of course.
Right.
I will turn into a cat.
So I'll instruct Yori to...
Fat, fluffy white cat.
Mm-hmm. To turn invisible and just keep an eye on
Mm. Alright, so Yuri will be keeping at a safe distance and flying high.
Can Fafnir dress time. Up as a gold cloak?
I can try.
Yeah.
But
only for an hour though.
Yeah. I mean, we don't intend to stay that long. And he can just he can't refresh, can he?
Refresh what?
The hat after an hour.
I'm not sure.
It will probably need some time to rest.
Hide in the closet.
Are we entering as well?
I don't know. I'll be a cat, but what will you guys be? Handmaidens.
We could.
You do have House Rose's handmaiden clothes, so.
I do, but if you're a cat, then, and I'm the handmaid, and I don't really know this place very well.
Yeah.
I'd be a very lost handmaid.
Oh, that happens a lot in the castle.
Ah!
Sersha, Exhibit A.
Okay, well in that case, I'll... Sure, why not? I'll be a handmaid.
Yeah.
And I'll have you next to me.
Keep me... Maybe you can, like, keep the coast clear. Just walk around. Then you communicate with Hellcat, and Hellcat will tell me where the gold cloaks would be, or the... like a walkie-talkie.
Wait, what? How? We're gonna go in through the secret entrance.
Yeah. Go through the tunnels in the castle. Because maybe we have you and Fafnir as the lookouts. But I don't know. About Fafnir.
Do you know where Peter lives?
Yeah.
His room is.
Yeah.
He's most likely going to be there.
Most likely.
Like,
he's more studious than I am.
I can... Why do you need to turn into a cat again?
Because people in the castle may recognize me despite the bushy eyebrows.
Okay. Well...
But in the streets, it'll be fine.
Okay, because I could walk with you to Peter's room, and while you're inside his room,
dust the vases outside.
Sure, Yuri can be with Fafnir. I don't know what Fafnir is gonna do. Maybe he'll just
keep a close eye on the exit. Maybe
which exit?
Secret entrance, tunnels, like where. Where we're gonna go in and out.
Okay.
Yeah.
Provided that he and I don't get lost. You do say that it's a thing in this house. Castle?
Yes.
Yeesh. Okay.
Mm.
So you won't be able to talk as a cat?
I won't. That's why I'll only turn into a cat once I enter the castle.
Oh boy.
Mm.
Okay, so I'm gonna don the handmaiden's
so
dress.
You find another crevice in the city in which you can safely change your clothes.
Mm.
Noon passes by, and as you begin to prepare for your excursion back into the tunnels to your city, we're gonna go ahead and call it a day. Until next week.
Okay. Castle. So that we know what Fafnir actually wants to do.
Yeah.
Castle. It's so hard being just three people.
Mm.